So folks, today we're checking out Sunsama. This is a task and calendar application which is priced at a fairly crazy $20 per month on their monthly plan. We're going to check out why it costs that much, how it works, and everything you need to know before committing to Sunsama. Today's video is sponsored by Tempo. Tempo's my go-to email client. It's a minimalist client for Mac and iOS, and its best feature is email batching. This means that it delivers emails in batches around your own customized schedule, which means less notifications and less distractions. You can connect up to 5 Gmail accounts, and they don't sell any of your data because they charge for Tempo. And their goal is to help you to reduce the amount of time you spend in email. They also removed all their hidden pixel tracking from emails, and they're perfect for folks who do their most important work outside of email, like designers, product owners, developers, and small to medium-sized business operators. I love using them, especially the sorting and focus mode features. It is fantastic, and it's definitely changed the way that I'm using email. You can check them out below with the link. It's so good to have them on as a sponsor this month. Thank you very much, and let's dive into our Sunsama review. So when you sign up to Sunsama, you get a 14-day free trial. And to begin, you do 2 core things. You start with a workflow questionnaire, which you answer a little bit about yourself. This isn't what's featured on screen. Then you begin. This is what's featured on screen, is what's called like a analysis. So you basically analyze your last working day and then you begin to plan your day. So it's quite interesting because they asked me questions about what I did the previous day, allowing me to work up to the projected hours of 6 to 8. And then what they did is they brought in my calendar for today and begin to start planning how much time I had for the day. Now, once I answer all of these, it begins to project it onto the screen. So then you can start planning, seeing your elements as well. Now, Sunsama is actually available on Mac OS and also web, and they do have an iOS and Android application, which you can access once you begin paying. So here we are with Sunsama. Now, as you can see here, it's very sort of similar to applications like Trello in its abilities. So what I can do here is on this left-hand panel, I can start skipping ahead. I can see the specific calendars that I have connected to the account, and I can also see channels as well. Now, channels is more in particular with the sort of time and where you spend it. So for example, context, you can add a personal context, you can add a work context, and it helps to sort of separate them out and see where you're spending your time in. So for example, if I wanted to see all of my personal tasks, I could create a base for them here. And if I wanted to see all of my work tasks, I haven't assigned any yet, then I could see them there. Now, the real sort of abilities that you get inside of Sunsama is the tasks and calendar. Now, tasks sit in the center here, although I can skip them around if I did want to, and you can see your calendar in front of you here. Now, if I go back to the task view, obviously you can see this in Kanban. I can make this a little bit bigger to get started, and I can start adding tasks. So up here, I can start adding tasks for the day, so I can add the task details, can tick it off, and even give it a start date, which is great for getting going. And also, I can give it the planned amount of time that it's due. So for example, I could say upload YouTube and press enter. So you can see up here as well, I've got a bit of a progress bar. So as I complete certain things, I can naturally get them ticked off. So if I tick this one off, you can see that quite a considerable amount got cleared there. And it helps me to see a sort of progress bar for the day. Now, we really like the fact that you can scroll ahead a couple of weeks if you want to, and even scroll backwards if you want to. On the web version, you're just using 2 fingers to move across the keyboard. And it's really nice because your calendar also follows you along. Now, you can also add a new task, and anything that you add obviously contributes to the amount of time, and you can also change the channel to it. So for example, in this case, I would want to change the channel to work, and if I pop this back open, you can see that work is now appearing here. So if you did want to start separating them, using it for both work and professional, that's quite a nice addition. Now, over this side, obviously I can see my calendar. If I want to, I can add a new Google Calendar event, and I can even create a Meet video conference as well, which is helpful. So it's sort of like getting a little bit of access to your Google Calendar all from there. Now, if I want to just discard this, just for example's case, I can see existing events as well. So for example, this is an upcoming meeting that I've attended, so you can actually select attendance. You can even run the meeting as well. So running the meeting is great for being able to start taking some agenda notes and some action items over here. And you can even start the meeting based on duration. You can share that too, which is pretty cool as well. So meetings are a little bit more interactive, but over on this hand side, you can see that I've got a Todoist connection and I can actually connect Todoist if I want to. I think I can connect a range of different applications, including likes of Trello, Asana, Gmail, ClickUp as well. But just for this example, the Todoist integration, if I press add to Todoist, I'm able to start getting the tasks that are inside of my Todoist in this account, which is perfect. Okay, so this is what the Todoist integration looks like. And you can see here that it's starting to bring in some of the different accesses I have inside of Todoist. Like even today, I could start dragging this in. Obviously, they're pretty similar, but if I wanted to say put zero accounting on Thursday, you can now see that's a Todoist task and you can start interacting with it. Or you can start bringing in some of the inbox stuff. So this is really helpful. And there's also a great refresh feature as well as the adjusting of the filters as well there. So that's a great way to be able to bring in different ones like that. And you've also got GitHub, Jira, Trello, Asana, Gmail and Outlook, and also ClickUp as well. And that's if you were to be able to bring in the Gmail threads that might be helpful. So these are all great ways to consolidate your experience into one base. Now, obviously over here, I've got weekly objectives. So this is more of a holistical week view. So for example, if I said upload 5 times YouTube, I can see that from a sort of big picture point of view. So if I were to start that on the Monday, obviously, you can see there that if I complete this, I can get it ticked off. And that's pretty helpful. I guess to be able to have a sort of zoom out view, I don't know whether it does interact with any of these. Obviously, if you have some key week objectives, you could drag them onto here. But in terms of like how, whether you zoom out or anything like that, I don't see anything like that. You can also see your backlog, which is quite nice because a lot of applications, you know, let's take Todoist, for example, they tend to hide this sort of stuff in, you know, like project folders and things like that. But a backlog with a linear view is quite nice as well. And obviously you'll be able to search that if you want to, or just see it in a list view too. You can also see an archive, which is tasks that have been rolled over at least 4 days consecutively. You can auto archive them or turn that off if you did want to. You can use a search for searching through all of the tasks and notes that you may be made inside of meetings. And there's this command bar, which I'll demonstrate in a minute. These are just updates. This new weekly objectives feature looks fairly new and allows you to sort of be a bit more sort of focused in the week. So there is a command bar. If you press command K, you can get access. So for example, if you were to say, oh, okay, here we go, align with objectives. So for example, so if I was like, okay, let's upload YouTube, I can go command K and I can press R or R here, capital R. I can also connect it to an objective. So now you can see that the objective becomes useful because that's aligned with the objective. That's quite a nice feature because I thought this would be quite useless, but you can see here that you can start connecting tasks to objectives. So that's a nice addition there. I do like that. So the other thing I haven't shown you is the actual ability. So for example, if I'm writing 3 Medium articles, I can add not only start dates, but due dates. I can also add subtasks. And over here, I can add a repeating one. I can begin to align it, or I can copy the link and create some notes down here. I can also start a timer, what it was planned for and what it was actually. And if you're in a team, you can add comments and add files here. I can open this up as a bit of a bigger focus, which I like. So for example, if you wanted to just be like, right, I'm working on this solely, and you can start writing down some objectives. So I could be like, why productivity sucks as an article. And then I could be like, right, I'm taking a short break, and I could close that. So that gives you a bit more of a more focused view, which I quite like that. It's a nice addition there. So you can also go to these different modes. So for example, if you want to focus on today, what happens is it just narrows down the options for you so that you can see only your day and your weekly objectives, which is a really nice view because what typically happens in applications like Todoist or Trello is you get looking at all of these other views or other things you're doing. And you can sometimes get distracted or maybe even have that priority crisis of like, oh God, what have I got to do? But having that's quite a nice sort of narrow down option. You can do that per day, but each day has, for example, if I wanted to plan tomorrow, you can use this sort of, how do you say it, like a guide to help you add in the events that you've got coming up. So these are ones. I can roll over any tasks that were completed yesterday, not completed yesterday. I could also bump back tasks that aren't essential, so I could defer certain work to the next day. But you can see here that because I've got these two events that are like 5 hours long, it's a clockwise integration that I haven't fully set up. But you can see it's gone over 8 hours and it's suggesting that I defer work to this day. So in this case, it's saying, you know, what can wait for tomorrow so that you don't overload yourself, which is quite a nice feature. And you can also finalize your planned shutdown time. So there we go. So you can see here that that's sort of the overview for today. And you can see here, plan for tomorrow, and you can post the obstacles in your way. You can customize this if you do want to as well. So include the subtasks, include private tasks, which is part of your private section, and include tasks completed on the previous day. So if I go apply, you can see that breakdown now, which is very cool. And you can even post this to Slack if you want. But if I want to, I can just get started. And there I have it, I've planned tomorrow, which is quite nice. So having that sort of guide, I always think it's like onboarding to some extent, is quite a good addition when it comes to planning ahead. Now it's saying create a private channel for my work. So I'm guessing this is that. So you can see here that if I go to edit, okay, here we go. So this is my private context. So anything here, I can modify the details of context as well. So if I want a different color, and I can also create a tertiary or more context as well. So moving forward, the calendar can be flipped around. So if you're somebody that's more time blocking centric, then this is a great way to be able to see your calendar in front of you. Now let's start with the week views. So you can actually go quite granular with the time framing. So in example, you can go 1 day, 3 days, weekdays, and even a week view and a month view as well. So that's really nice in terms of being able to planning ahead. I quite like the 3 day view, which is quite nice. And what's nice as well is you can still get access to the focus and plan ahead for these guys. So I can switch back whenever I want to, and that's quite helpful for being able to access everything there. Okay, so up in the top left-hand corner, you can see that I've got a couple of things. I wanna go over account settings and things like that. I'm obviously not using the Mac version, but obviously that would work better. I even set when I started, my day starts at 9:30 and when it ends. So you can actually have, you know, where you set your day and start the day and automatically daily shutdown as well, and a workload sort of threshold too. You can have an automated weekly review, and also you can go into a lot more detail about, like, you know, when and what your calendar shows, as well as the task rollover and much more detail like that, like enter focus timer as you start the timer. You can choose dark mode as well, which is nice. I'll keep it on that. Then you can modify things like the notifications. So what you get accessed, you can connect it to Slack and be able to sort of get Slack updates from there, especially if you're working in a team. So you can change the workplace settings. So here are some of the integrations as well, quite helpful specifically. So for example, you can see what types of privacy you've got set up. Email forwarding as well, if you want to send tasks on. And you can also see your calendars as well, which ones are connected. So in this case, I could add an Outlook or a Google Calendar too. Now, here we go, is a weekly review. So this is a way to reflect for the week ahead. So the weekly reflection questions are, where did I spend my most time, and are there any surprises? Also some two more here. You can also export that weekly review too. I haven't quite got to that, but that could be quite cool. Obviously it's a 14-day free trial. As I said, the monthly pricing is $20. So obviously you'll be looking at this at sort of a bigger pricing. It's probably gonna solve your calendar and your task issues if you're gonna commit to it, because it's quite a steep price for that. But let me share my opinion with you guys. So I think this is, from like first inspection, I was like, no one should pay this much for a to-do list application. But if I'm honest, I really like the way this consolidates information. I like the way that they take you through and onboard certain things. Don't get me wrong, I don't think the pricing should be this much, but I do like the way they're approaching tasks and calendar events and the way that they're trying to get you to narrow down your focus for the day, not overload yourself, and help you plan ahead. I like that. That's something that a lot of people can struggle with. And also the consolidation is pretty helpful too, in being able to use it alongside apps that you might already use or transition over from. Now the mobile applications are available on Android and iOS, so you're not getting too much disaccess there. However, $16 per month if you go for the yearly plan, or $20 It's fairly steep. I'll probably pay up to 15 for this application. So it sort of falls into the pricing. I'm impressed with this app. It's more for, I would say it's more for those who want a more focused system. Those who are happy to maybe drop a calendar application for the sake of having tasks and calendar in one location. It's for those who really want to stay focused during their work, who struggle with planning, and maybe who want to bring in other applications that they use as a team and be able to consolidate them in one application. So I think it's actually more impressive than I thought. I did do a review on Sunsama a couple of years ago, but it was much more basic than this, and it's definitely improved in the near future. So folks, a big thank you for stopping by. There'll be a link to Sunsama below, but those are my opinions and thoughts on this application. I really like its approach. It's a little bit more premium. However, for those who are looking for a task calendar consolidation tool, this might be the application for you. So thank you very much, folks. Hopefully this was a great overview to make that decision to go with Sunsama. Anyway, folks, talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.